guys, today we are going to discuss the formation of legs. Now before we see how legs are formed, we are supposed to know what are legs. Legs are troughs or depression on the earth surface on which water collects. Now, legs are formed in different ways. We have natural, ones that were formed naturally, and we have others that were formed, we call them natural, and others are formed by human activity. We say human activity. Now, what are these legs that were formed naturally? We call them natural legs. Now, these ones are grouped into categories. We have A, B, and C. We want to look at them one by one, beginning with natural legs. Now, natural legs are also, we have number one, we have these ones that are known as Rift Valley legs. They are mainly Rift Valley legs. Rift Valley legs, these were formed naturally. Now, these Rift Valley legs are narrow, wide, and long. We have others fresh, and others are salty. Now, these Rift Valley lakes, we have others that are fresh. We call them fresh water lake, and others are salty. We call them salty water lakes. Like for example, looking at the salty water lakes, we have examples of these ones. We have example like Lake Nakuru. We have Elementaita. Lake Magadi. We have another one, Lake Bogoria is another salty water lake. And we have others that are fresh. We call them fresh water lakes. And these fresh water lakes, basically, I hope you know them. We have Lake Naivasha is an example of fresh water lake. Lake Turkana is another example. We have Lake Baringo is a fresh water lake. You have to differentiate. Lake Baringo is a fresh water and Lake Bogoria is salty water. Many students get confused between Baringo and Bogoria, which one is fresh, which one is salty. Baringo is fresh and Bogoria is salty. Now, fresh water lakes, and we have said these Rift Valley lakes, they are grouped into two. Others are salty and others are fresh, and we have seen examples of fresh water lake. We've seen these examples of fresh water lakes include Lake Baringo, Lake Naivasha, and the many more examples we have seen. There are very many. And the salty water, we have also looked at examples of salty water lakes. Now, another formation of lakes that we are going to look at or to study, there are lakes formed by volcanic action. Lake formed by volcanic action. These are natural volcanic action. Lake formed by volcanic action. Iron. Now, these are groups into two. These formed by volcanic action are grouped into two. We have crater lakes, and we also have lava dam lakes. But let us begin with crater lakes. How are these crater lakes formed? These are found on top of volcanic ponds or extension. Now, these crater lakes are found on the top of volcanic. They mainly collect on the top of volcanic. Now they collect on top of volcanic cone. They collect somewhere here. Now this is a mountain. Now we find them, they collect on the top. Now, volcanic mountain, we have seen how they are formed. They are formed on the top of this volcanic. Now, the water collects somewhere here. So these are examples of crater lakes. Now we are going to look at examples of crater lakes that are found in Uganda and in Kenya. Now, in Uganda, examples we have like Katwe and Lake Nungu. We have Katwe, Katwe in Uganda, and Nungu, and Lake Nungu. These are examples of crater lakes, Lake Katwe and Lake Nungu. In Ethiopia, we have Lake Shala, and in Tanzania, we have Lake Ngozi. In Kenya, we have Paradise and Lake Chala. Now, Paradise, we have said in Uganda we have Katwe and Nungu, and in Ethiopia I've said we have Lake Shala, in Tanzania we have Lake Ngozi, and in Kenya we have Paradise and Lake Chala. These are examples of volcanic lakes, the examples of crater lakes. They are known as volcanic. They are formed through volcanic action. These are natural, formed naturally. We have also another one called Lava Dam. Example, we have Lava Dam Lake. These are just examples of volcanic. We have Lava Dam Lake, Lava Dam, Lava Dam, Lava Dam Lakes. What are these Lava Dam Lakes? These Lava Dam Lakes are formed when the lava flows and block the flowing of a river. When lava flows and block the flowing of a river, a Lava Dam Lake is formed. Let us see how Lava Dam Lake was formed. Now, when the lava flow, for example, take this mountain, then we see how it was formed. When the lava flow like this, now, when the lava flow, it blocks the flow of a. It blocks the flow of a river, and then a lake is formed here called Lava Dam, called Lava Dam Lake. Lava Dam Lake is formed. The lava flows and block the flow of a river. If this river was flowing like this, and then the lava flows, and then it block. When it blocks this river, it blocks this river from flowing. This elsewhere, this lake is formed. This lake that is formed here is what is known as Lava Dam Lake. And we are going to look at examples of Lava Dam Lakes that are found in Uganda. We have example in Lake Matundu and Lake Bunyoni and Kivu in Uganda. In Uganda, we have Lake Matundu, yes, Lake Bunyoni, we have Lake Matundu, Lake Bunyoni, and Lake Kivu. Those are examples of Lava Dam Lake that are found in Uganda. We also have in Ethiopia, we have Lake Tana. Lake Tana is another example of Lava Dam Lake. And Lake Ruhondo in Rwanda. We have Ruhondo in Rwanda. Those are examples of Lava Dam Lake. Now, we are going to look at another example called lakes that were formed as a result of downwarping. Downwarping. Now, hope you have understood how volcanic lakes were formed. Now we are going to look at lakes that were formed as a result of downwarping.